Okay, now this is your very important slide showing your torsades de pointis, right? So let's talk about torsades de pointis. So if I draw a simple, you know, tracing of your torsades de pointis, it will come somewhat like this, right? So the amplitude, the QRS amplitude will be changing, right? Here it is more, then there will be low, then again there will be more, right? So the QRS amplitude is changing. This may progress to ventricular fibrillation, and this may be caused by drugs that decrease potassium or decrease magnesium and other congenital abnormalities, right? So the causes are mainly drugs. Also, the conditions that decrease potassium, the conditions that decrease magnesium, and some congenital abnormalities, all these are causes of your torsades de pointis. So causes are drugs, the conditions that decrease potassium, conditions that decrease magnesium, and other congenital abnormalities. Main important point is the treatment here. Remember, treatment is your Maxalf, magnesium sulfate, right? So there will be change in amplitude of the QRS and twisting of the QRS complex. See, the so there is a change in the amplitude of the QRS and twisting of the QRS complex, right, around the isoelectric line. Just see the changing of the this one amplitude of the QRS. Here it is more, then less, again it's more, right? So there is a change in the amplitude and twisting of the QRS complex. Now short, long, short pattern of the RR cycles, as I mentioned, and usually there's a warm up phenomenon, and frequently terminates spontaneously. Anyway, the first two being the characteristic of your torsades de pointis, and treatment is your Maxalf, and causes are your drugs and the conditions that decrease potassium, decrease magnesium, and other congenital abnormalities. All right.